Genetic modification is a real thing. It's going to change the world, just like James Taylor changed rock and roll.
Hello, Martha's Vineyard. Are you ready to watch me play guitar on a stool?
Yes, thank you.
No, thank you. Now here's a song that's basically directions to Boston.
Oh man, this is the happiest day of my life. Now I know how Barbara Streisand must have felt the day she married James Brolin.
I love you.
I love you too. Ah, I'm so glad I married a regular person and not a celebrity.
I'm really cutting loose, just like Julie Andrews in that movie where she showed her breasts.
Oh, Mary, you'll never leave us, will you? Yes, those are lovely, but it doesn't quite answer our question.
Okay, Johnny Depp or Richard Grieco?
Oh, that's gross.
Let's not do this.
Come on. If you're secure in your masculinity, you can answer a simple hypothetical.
All right, Johnny Depp, because he kind of looks like a chick, I guess.
What about you, Peter?
Oh, man. I don't know. Richard Grieco would probably appreciate you more. You know, not take you for granted. I mean, with Johnny Depp, it's like he wouldn't really need you. You know, he'd probably sneak out after you fell asleep. Of course, with Johnny, you get the financial security. I'd go with Johnny.
And now back to Old People Agree with Arnold Palmer.
Tomato soup, grilled cheese, and a weak cup of tea is the best lunch in my book.
He's right.
I enjoy things I remember.
Plenty of people cheat. Once again, Ashley Simpson.
That's how I won friends when I worked for E. Seabiscuit! Seabiscuit! Would you mind talking to E?
I'm not Seabiscuit. I'm Penelope Cruz.
And you're just lovely. Would you like a carrot? Good girl.
This is the best idea I've had since I slayed that dragon. Sybil Shepherd?
Yes.
People, you are free!
Ugh, if he dies, I'm gonna have to start hanging out with The Rock again.
One's a baby, and the other's black, I think. At least part black. Or Hispanic. I think, you know, possibly there's some Filipino in there. Yeah, possibly some Filipino. I mean, if he's black, it's definitely diluted. I mean, one of his parents must be white. What the hell is Jessica Alba, for that matter? If I were 40 years younger, I would plow that till next July.
Now I know how Alec Baldwin feels when he feeds his brothers.
There you go. There you go. Eat up, Stephen. You're the weakest.
Hey, bud, take a break. I'll take over. Go smoke a fatty.
Thanks.
This is Sierra Tango 817, Matthew McConaughey's private jet, requesting permission to land.
Matthew McConaughey? Oh, sorry, Sierra Tango 817. All our runways are filled.
But it looks empty from up here. We're almost out of fuel.
No room at all. But lucky for you, there's a big new airport out in the middle of the ocean. Keep going. You can't miss it.
Roger that.
Oops. Well, look at it this way. I just got you on next year's Oscar telecast. You'll be right after Ron Howard! Just messing with you, Ron. Or maybe not! No, seriously, I am. Or am I? No.
We now return to Tony Danza and Sylvester Stallone in... What?
Hey!
Hey!
Hey, hello!
What? You can be successful writers like Ben Affleck and Matt Damon.
Huh, there, finished. Good Will Hunting by Matt Damon.
Hey, you think we could put both our names on that?
What? You've done nothing but eat briars and smoke pot for the last 6 months.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Come on, I helped.
Oh, yeah? Okay, write a line. Just right now. Just pitch me a line right now.
Okay. How about that?
That wasn't a line. You just farted.
Is there any more pot?
Are you kidding, Brian? These men and their redneck lifestyle really speak to me. This is the greatest show I've seen in years. Not like the last time I was at a comedy club. I hear this guy's hilarious. He played Kramer, you know.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
been a worse wife than Lorena Bobbitt when she was married to the Thing.
Oh my God, where is it? Where'd she throw it? Oh God, oh God!
Is this what you're looking for?
Hey, hey, some of our greatest actors started in news, like Sean Penn.
Today's weather calls for, breezy skies and sun, and there's gonna be a... Get that camera out of my face!
Sometimes people just need a little encouragement to succeed, like Jason Biggs got from his grandfather.
Jason, I want you to promise me one thing. Always be forgettable.
I will, Grandpa.
Hey, that's just a regular unattractive guy who's not famous.
We did it, Grandpa.
You don't want to mess this up, like Skeelo messed up his wishes.
I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a rabbit in a hat with a bat.
Skeelo?
What?
You need money.
All right, fine. Guess I'm not the first person to cave into family pressure, like Stephen Baldwin.
Why aren't you a bloated alcoholic yet?
I'm sorry, Ma!
Can I talk to someone else? Literally anyone?
I'm Gilbert Gottfried, and I was fired by Affleck for no reason.
Well, there was some reason.
I'm staying, and I'm running the company with Big Bird, since he's at HBO now.
I'm actually Gwendolyn Christie. I played Brienne on Game of Thrones. I fear I may be a bit late.
You get the company!
You ain't ever getting that invite to dinner with the Gyllenhaals. Muddy was right. He never got invited to dinner with Jake Gyllenhaal or his sleepy-eyed sister. Which is probably for the best. She looks like she chews with her mouth open.
Looks like someone learned how to fight.
Yeah, I got a whole Karate Kid thing.
What's that? I'm only allowed to watch Kirk Cameron movies.
Ah, you poor dude.
Out.
Are you serious? You cannot be serious!
I had a hard time telling if people were serious.
I spilled spot remover on my dog, and now he's gone.
Are you serious? Look, they even have the payphone Denise Huxtable would call from on a different world. Hi, Dad. College is great.
I'm doing what I want to actresses, and will get support from my wife, Camille.
That stuff was more out in the open than I remember.
He's angrier than Al Pacino's forehead liver spots.
Comb your hair down instead of up. Give us some shade. We're dying up here.
Yeah, what do you call that haircut? You're nearly 80 years old. You look like the kid from Jerry Maguire.
What are you going for with all of these spots?
I want to look like mashed potatoes with the skins on.
When the Dwayne Johnson Center for Confusion Ethnicity approached me about hosting this night, I said it'd be an honor to bestow upon Stuart Gilligan Griffin our Lifetime Achievement Award.
I'll tell you what I was thinking. I was thinking we lived in a safe neighborhood, but apparently I was wrong.
Wait, you're saying you were wrong?
Oh, I get it. The Fonz can't say wrong.
No, Peter, he's 70. He's having a stroke.
And let's be honest, if I had stayed with the Griffins, I would have ended up like Rick Springfield today.
I wish that I had Jesse's job.
We now return to Bryan Cranston Sneezes.
Achoo! Thank you.
I even managed Earth, Wind, Fire, and Pollen for a little while, but I had to give it up.
Do you remember?
Achoo! September is the worst month for pollen.
All the most important Broadway people will be there. Playwrights, money men, even Stanley Kowalski.
Hi, I'm Michael.
Michael! Michael!
And this is my wife, Nancy.
Nancy! Nancy!
And this is our Uzbekistani friend, Boykyar Vroychescu.
Hi. I brought a gift. Put it to your ear. You can hear the ocean.
It's broken or something. All I hear is...
It's Billy Ocean. Oh, God. I got loads more.
I think you and I are going to have a lot of fun together. Well, that doesn't sound good. All right, I'm going to go out and look for him. I'll take my Don Don.
Well, I can't go outside. It's cold out there.
Tom, I'm standing here with Stephen Hawking, the first white man I've ever met who knows math better than me. Mr. Hawking, what does the discovery of this black hole mean to you and your research?
I am overjoyed. This is the crowning achievement of my career. It validates the work of a lifetime.
It certainly does. Back to you, Tom.
All right, we're clear.
I'm telling you, man, this shtick is getting so old. That chair smells, dude.
Hey, Steve, surf's up!
All right, see ya, bitch.
Oh, well, I guess sometimes you're just right for the part. Like James Earl Jones playing Darth Vader.
So, James, we just want you to do the voice.
From Time Life Music comes a one-of-a-kind Rat Pack collection, their most bigoted songs. All your favorite once-acceptable hits like Drunk Old Engine.
The drunk old engine squatting in his teepee. Fire water keeping him warm.
Jewish Nose.
She's got a big, beautiful Jewish nose, and it's there 2 minutes early wherever she goes.
Dean Martin singing Chinaman's Chants.
And Mr. Chinaman saying his Chinaman way. A ding a ling a ching a chong a ching a chong choo.
Pew Stinky Frenchman.
Paris is lovely and Nice sure is nice. And Marseille is charming with champagne on ice. But you stinky Frenchmen haven't a clue. Pew stinky Frenchmen, frog you.
Hey there, Fruity.
Hey there, Fruity, you can do my hair. Hey there, Fruity,
don't touch me down there.
Hey there, Fruity, you're gay and I don't approve.
And many more.
Yeah, like that old gypsy did to Britney Spears in that Stephen King book.
Thicker.
Where the devil is everyone? This place is more deserted than James Gandolfini's workout room.
Great. This was a bigger waste of time than Ringo's songwriting.
Hey guys, I wrote a song.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, good, Ringo.
Fantastic.
You know what? I'm gonna put it right here. Right on the refrigerator. That way we'll get to see it every day.
All right. Ugh, will you please hurry up? It's 100 degrees out here. Ugh, you're a worse parent than Britney Spears.
I know. Oh, the gift basket was not worth the trip. Not by a long shot. Oh, I gotta get that. I'll talk to you later.
Oh, I say, this is an even bigger accomplishment than getting Minnie Driver's head to fit on screen.
Okay, back up. Further. Move back some more.
What?
Back up some more.
I'm as far away as I can get.
Okay, have her enter. Action. Damn it. Cut.
Oh my God. Oh my God, what's happening to me? I'm like that Texas woman who gave her son brain damage by holding him underwater. I'm just like Barbara Bush.
I haven't seen this much denial since John Travolta married Kelly Preston.
John, do you take Kelly to be your wife?
I totally do. I mean, yeah, yes, absolutely. And I'm gonna do stuff to her too, like touch her? Yeah, touch her and kiss her and touch her penis. I mean, no, not that.
Trust me, it makes it that much more special when we finally get inside and see Renee Zellweger doing her whole scrunch face routine.
Coming this March, Jude Law and Renee Zellweger in The Picnic.
Oh no, these ants are ruining our picnic.
You mean this picnic is ruining our ants?
Oh, don't try to deny it, pretty baby. You've been down so long you can hardly see.
Hey, Stewie, 3 o'clock, time for The View.
No, not again!
Yeah, let me out of here! I can't watch another second!
Yeah, this is worse than being Kevin Federline's magic mirror.
Magic mirror, how can I look like a douchebag today?
Well, Kevin, I would say, first of all, don't shave or shower.
Okay, I won't.
And, you just got out of bed, right?
Yeah.
I would say just go ahead and wear that tank top all day.
Okay.
All right, so we cover the hygiene, no collared shirts, oh, and don't forget to walk around with an undeserved sense of accomplishment.
Dinner's almost ready, kids.
Wow, Lois, look at you. You're like Britney Spears. Except you're not a fat guy.
Oh, that's easy. I wish I could see what Kelly Ripa was like off the set.
So it shall be.
Great show today, Kelly.
Thanks, Reg. You too.
Hey, Kelly,
Gelman needs us on stage for a couple of reshoots.
Be right there, Reege. I just have to put on my face.
Oh, yes, with this close to sign.
Oh, Keanu Reeves, wow. You know, I don't usually gush, so you'll have to forgive me, but when I was writing Coast Guard, that's what I do, I'm a writer. Anyway, when I was writing Coast Guard, I couldn't think of anyone other than, there's a woodpecker on your head.
Yeah, he comes and goes.
Ooh, how deliciously evil-looking. He's like something out of Stephen King.
Okay, for my 307th book, this couple is attacked by a lamp monster.
Ooh, ooh.
You're not even trying anymore, are you? When can I have it?
Oh man, I better save my autographed picture of Dean Cain. You know, from before he got all desperate for attention.
Hey, is that Dean Cain on that park bench?
Oh God.
You know you're a redneck when your gun rack has a gun rack on it.
You suck!
Boy, am I beat.
Peter, what's with the tie?
Oh, I bought a tie so I can loosen it when I'm beat.
Oh my God, Dad!
Peter, your breath, it's horrible.
Is Whoopi Goldberg working out down there? Brian, either you cooperate or I blow my Adam Levine dog whistle.
Hey, my voice isn't that high.
It is. It is, though.
Unless you rip it, no one gets away until they whip it. I say whip it.
Okay.
Ugh! Whip it good.
I'm doing my very best.
Thanks. That was way too much heat on my neck.
And now, international news from Al Jazeera, Jazeera.
Car bombing in Syria, skiddly boom bopba dee, yeah. 37 people killed, ooh, the people are dead.
Face it, you're a worse parent than Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie.
I'm concerned about Pax, Maddox, and Shiloh. They're having trouble adapting. They've been raised with 11 languages and really don't speak any.
I hear you, Doctor. So, you're saying we should give them all faux hawks?
No, I think they need intensive therapy.
Let me see if I understand you. Even shorter on the sides?
I'm just going to take a little bit of his DNA, and soon we'll be proud parents, like Ron Livingston's parents.
You know, our son's a famous actor.
Really? What's his name?
He was like the main guy in Office Space.
Yeah, what else? He has dark hair. I don't know. Was he in Black Hawk Down? He was in, like, at least 5 Sex in the Cities.
Ugh, what is his name? What is his name? Is your son Ron Livingston?
Yes!
Oh, God! Thank God!
Ron Livingston, thank you. That has been bugging me all day.
Yeah, if we don't find that tape, we're screwed. Like anybody who goes scuba diving with Dave Navarro. It's amazing what you find when you clean your basement.
Peter, you almost done down there?
Look what I found.
That's wonderful, Peter.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go do some skywriting.
Wow, she seems great. We're getting along better than Whitney Houston and Bobby Brown.
You wanna smoke some crack?
I love you.
Get the crack!
I guess you're right. Look how Chris Brown turned on Drake.
Bitch, stop pushing up on my hoes before I kick your punk ass!
Oh, pardon. I didn't mean any offense, hip-hop colleague. Can an African-Canadian just rap about neat things and drink Sprite?
I've screwed up worse than Disney did when they cast Michael J. Fox in that Zorro remake!
Who was that masked man who saved us?
I don't know, but he left his insignia.
Wait a minute, you mean we can't have sex?
No.
But, Peter, we're married.
Tony Randall was married, Lois. Rock Hudson was married. Ronald Reagan was married.
Mr. President, did you reach a missile pact?
Well, you could say that. There was a missile, and something definitely got packed.
Hey, look, why don't you go bother Joe, huh?
I can't. He's in Vegas for the weekend, seeing that handicapped Cher impersonator.
This is the biggest sitting ovation I've ever seen!
You'll forgive him, just like Kathleen Turner forgave her mirror.
Sorry. Turns out you were right about me.
Whoosh! I hate him! His mouth is always open like P. Diddy.
Well, what do you mean?
You ever notice how in every photo of P. Diddy, his mouth is hanging open?
Well, actually, Diddy hired a guy to close his mouth for him.
I'm telling you, this kid is the next Justin Bieber. Young girls love him, but he makes real music that...
Sorry I'm late. Traffic.
Look, there's only one way to settle this. Only the artist knows the true meaning of their art.
Now, Miss O'Keefe, the flowers in your paintings, what do they represent?
Oh, wow, that's a really good question.
Indeed, a force to be reckoned with, like Secretary of Energy Stephen Chu. Secretary Chu, Ways and Means has sent over a preliminary budget. It looks like the Department of Energy is looking at a 4% budget cut. Okay, no budget cut.
No budget cut.
I like him.
Really? Seems kind of lame. But I guess every girl has her own version of Prince Charming.
I'm in love with Paul.
I'm in love with John.
You know what? I'm in love with Ringo.
What?
I don't know what I said.
Sounded like you said you were in love with Ringo.
I don't think so.
Pretty sure you said I'm in love with Ringo. Here I am.
Are Paul and John out there?
Nope, just Ringo.
I guess you learn something new every day. Like the black-eyed peas.
Hey, what's that?
This is a guitar.
Wow.
She's always making me feel small and insignificant, like John Goodman's heartbeat.
Honey? My inside left boob stomach did that thing again.
You mean your heart?
I don't know about any of that, but I think I should eat something.
Fine, go ahead. But I'm telling you, it's going to be a bigger waste of time than writing tough guy dialogue for a Jet Li movie.
This is your last warning. Give me back my wife.
What? Excuse me?
Give me back my wife, or you're in a lot of trouble. I'll kick all your faces. You got me?
You're kind of undoing everything you just did when you kicked my ass.
I know, but I have to say for audience.
They found a body of a war hero down by the old asylum.
Okay, that has to be something.
Sorry, Peter. I'm just singing along with this old John Mellencamp song.
They went up there without a movie. Peter Quagmire, Cleveland, and Joe. Killed the old janitor, war hero. Just why, we'll never know.
I don't remember this one. Guess it's never been in a car commercial.
In a truck that spilled Dodge Tough.
Oh, yeah, no, I know this one.
Oh, God, this is already hard to watch. Like that Bourne movie where they couldn't get Matt Damon.
We're facing a biochemical attack of untold proportions. Unfortunately, Jason Bourne is not available.
Who have we got?
We have the sixth build guy from the Avengers. The arrow guy who frowns a lot.
Okay. Does he look like Bourne?
Yeah. He sort of looks like a young Popeye.
Well, sounds like he's the right guy for this.
Yeah.
Mr. Griffin, you're the most generous man since Ted Turner.
I'd like to announce I'm giving a gift the whole world can appreciate. I've colorized the moon.
All right, now we're going to use a fan brush here, and I want you to take some Hunter Green, and we're going to put a happy little bush right down over here in the corner there. And that'll just be our little secret. And if you tell anyone that that bush is there, I will come to your house and I will cut you.
All right? What's more important is we're living a sweet life, huh? This is even more fun than when I performed at the White House.
Mr. President, I present to you Peter Griffin.
Booga 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 blah 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 blah.
Thank you. I'm having a good time, too. I hope I don't make any social faux pas like I did at Pamela and Tommy Lee's dinner party. Hi, sorry I'm late. I was visiting my aunt in the hospital. She has hepatitis.
Sorry.
Lois, you're in an auto parts store stealing mufflers. This is worse than that Winona Ryder thing.
Are you saying I'm a klepto?
Actually, I was talking about the age of innocence. It is settled, May. Our parents have consented, and you and I are to be married on the first warm, sunny day of spring.
That would be most good, Newland. Most good.
I'm sorry, but she is just awful. Is there any way, I mean, can we add like a topless scene or something?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
We can? Oh, great. All right, we got a movie.
Don't worry, Lois. Peter's good at getting out of trouble. Just like Kobe Bryant.
We want the truth, Kobe. Did you rape her?
Ooh!
What were we talking about?
That was my pleasure too, Peter.
I knew I'd get you. Just like Danny DeVito got Rhea Perlman.
I don't know, Danny.
Look, it's either me or nobody.
Sold.
That's a great idea, Peter.
Sweet. And I promise you'll be able to understand all the words. Not like Sting, where you can only understand the last three.
Starting up a brand new day.